Welcome you to the Unamuno Author Series. This is number 19, believe it or not. And I have two more amazing poets here in Madrid for the first time ever, Jordan Zandi and Henri Cole, both of whom's poetry I admire very, very much. So this is just a quick moment to have a little conversation before the reading starts. The room is filling up. And I thought I'd ask both of you what you think of this series.
I'm very impressed.
It's been a lot of fun. Yeah, you think it's a good idea?
I've been pushed down my comfort zone. That's all right.
Yeah. And what do you think of Madrid?
Henri, what do you think of Madrid?
I'd always read.
Well, I think it's great. I love those misting machines that are everywhere, yes. Moistening all the people that are sitting and having cocktails.
What do you think
about? Write a short story about this.
And I love being surrounded by language here in this little bookshop. Wherever I go in the world, I always feel most at home when I'm with the English language. And that's where we are right now, and very, very far from home.
What do you think of the idea of having a series like this in a foreign country that's bringing in a lot of English-speaking poets?
I think it's a real high honor for American literature to be received this way so far from, you know, its origin. Yeah, I think it's great. I salute you for making this happen, for it being possible. I think we're the 19th, you said?
Yeah, number 19.
The 19th event of all these wonderful American poets that have preceded us.
One thing that it's brought to me is that, you know, I think when I was living in America 6 or 7 years ago, sometimes it felt like poetry was very isolating and I was separated from a lot of writers, and this has just brought everybody into my living room. And there's a lot of love in the poetry community among the many, many different poets that have come. So, what are you working on now?
I'm just trying to start new poems. Every new poem is just as hard as the one before it.
And what about that prose book? When is that coming out?
I have a nonfiction work, which is part autobiography, part prose poem, part essay, photography, called Orphic Paris. It'll come out next spring. I went to New York.
Very intense. That's new, different.
Yes, but I wonder about Jordan. Jordan's going to read new work tonight.
Yes.
Yes, Jordan.
Quite a few.
What about poems?
Yeah, they're kind of together. I think I've started more than I finished. I seem to have almost a book's worth of started poems, but only about 15 pages of finished poems. But a lot of them are long sequences, so they can take a couple years to finish. So I'll read one of those.
Oh, great.
Jordan and I were both, Jordan with his wife and I separately were both at the Prado.
Yeah.
Just looking at the paintings of Goya and much else.
The Garden of Earthly Delights.
Yeah.
I think my favorite painting in the whole museum was by Antonello da Messina, which is an angel supporting a Christ.
Oh.
A very limp, dying Christ.
Yeah.
There are only a handful of paintings of his in the whole world, and one of them is here. I saw one or two of them at Sicily. He worked in Sicily, so it was a pleasure to find one here.
Great. Well, I think that...
Do you want to tell us something about yourself?
I'm the founder of this series. This is number 19. We'll be back in September. We'll have Dana Prescott, who's going to be coming from Italy. She's sharing an anthology with us. And Rick Barat will be here.
Dana's anthology, they're all poems about...
Jennifer Groats will be here as well in September.
They're all poems about an Italian painter.
Exactly, you're in it. Yeah, he's in the anthology.
It's cool.
So I hope you'll join us again in September, and thanks so much for supporting us. We're planning a festival in 2019 with hopefully Patti Smith heading that up, and we'll have a series of filmed interviews of all the poets with Elise Durant, who works for Woody Allen. So that's what's coming up. Thank you.